Okay. Okay. My name is Simi Bohuslav, and I'll be reading my story. The Publishers. This is a tale of two towns, illiteracy and literacy, justice and injustice. Here's Xavier explaining Martha, she tagged her brother Xavier. Xavier chased his sister into the house. His skin was as dirty as a rat, and as rough, of course, as a beaten up boxer. Having worked in the presses for 10 years, he's 16. His hair was dark and matted and permanently stained from the black ink. Xavier lived in Black and White Town, a town with just one street, where black people lived on one side and white people on the other. The town was a book town. The white side wrote the books, and the black side printed and binding books. The black people couldn't read. At the end of the town, there was a library which was divided in half. The black side was horribly flooded. Books were on the floor, and smashed like they had sat outside for a couple of years. The shelves were made out of chipped wood that was wet and moldy. The floor of frayed carpet and paint was peeling from the walls. Even though it was a cave, people on the black side were proud of their library. On the white side of the library, the white walls were neatly painted. Expressionless monuments lined the walls and stared aimlessly into the streets. The air smelled sterile like a bathroom that's just been cleaned. While clean, the lights of the library was boring. Okay, we have 300 books to publish today. Go, 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 screamed the boss. Xavier felt a surge of restlessness and began to run. Where are you going, Xavier yelled his dad. Xavier bolted past houses, past the library, and then out of town. Then he saw something strange. Another town. As he entered the town, he saw black and white people on both sides and thought, this place is gorgeous. Compared to my town, the monuments look so real. They're so well-maintained. They're so vivid that they feel like my neighbor. The town smells like fresh baguette and flowers are all over. And wow, there are groups of people that are mixed. As he walked around, he bumped into a black girl with raven black long hair and a deep bun that glimmered in the sun. Sorry, Xavier, he always said as he stopped in his tracks. What's your name? I'm Angela, she said shyly. Who are you? I'm Xavier. Where are we? We're in a great town, replied Angela. Where do you come from? I'm from Black and White Town, replied Xavier. How can black people walk on both sides of the streets here? And who takes care of the streets to keep them so clean? And Joe stared for a moment, bewildered, and then questioned softly, why wouldn't it be this way? We all take care of the streets. It's our town, and we want it to look good. Wow, that's awesome. Would you mind showing me around? Sure, let me take you to the library, my favorite spot in the whole town. They walked half a block until they came to a big blue wooden building. Inside, there were more books than Xavier had ever seen. Probably 5 times as many books as the library in the Black and White Town. Angela continued, here's the section with the books on the ancient Egyptian history. It's my favorite. I love reading about the pharaohs and pyramids. Xavier's jaw dropped. You can read? Of course. I learned in school when I was 5. Xavier looked outside and noticed the sun was starting to set. He said, Angela, thank you for showing me this incredible spot. I must leave now so that my family doesn't worry. Angela's mom, you're welcome. I hope to see you again. As Xavier ran home, questions raced through his head. Against the backdrop of the painted sky, he felt excited, curious, and saw the possibility of a better future. Thank you.